Hello, everyone. Today is Wednesday, September 4th, 2013. It's time to play some Wonky Wednesday GeoGuessr. I do want to thank everyone who has been playing these crazy, crazy awesome games of GeoGuessr. Congrats, I saw a lot of really crazy good scores on Monday's game, on Monday Mayhem. And I know that, again, the jury is still out. I do have more people saying that they like Wonky Wednesday, comparatively speaking to people who don't like Wonky Wednesday, so it's going to stick around for a little bit. And basically how it goes, if you've never played Wonky Wednesday before, basically it's 5 30-second rounds, and the object is to get the lowest score possible. So you want to try to get as far away from your location as possible within 30 seconds. There are a couple of constraints. First and foremost, you cannot put it anywhere in the middle of the ocean. And secondly, you have to put your cursor, your guess, on somewhere that is named. It has to be a named country or continent or something like that. And last but not least, you cannot put anything on the North or South Poles or Antarctica. So the furthest north you can go is, I believe, Greenland. The furthest south you can go is Australia, or if you want to get technical, maybe somewhere in the South African region of the globe. Anyway, you will see how it is. Good luck, have fun, everyone, for Wonky Wednesday. 3, 2, 1, let us begin, and we're off. And for those of you wondering why is this even a thing, because it is still technically kind of important for you to figure out where you are in the world, so you can adequately guess. Or make a good guesstimate to where the farthest point from your spot is. Some people said, "Oh, you just put it in the same place all the time." You can't. Okay, so here you go. So I'm in Russia. So I'm gonna say, right there on South America. I don't even know what country that is. All right. So yeah, 77 points, not bad. If you can get under 100 points per round, you're doing way, way good. And that looked like it was close to. Where is that? It looks like about. A little bit southwest of, or southeast of, no, southwest of Moscow, that's what I meant. 77 points, not too bad. Round two! Oh. So that looks pretty Korean. Yeah, ooh, this is a pretty temple. Very pretty temple. I'm pretty sure that's Korean. I don't think that's, I know it's not Japanese. It could be Chinese, but I'm still gonna say it's Korea. So, if it's Korea, which is right there, I'm guessing somewhere in South Africa is probably going to be, it was South Korea. And, I actually don't know where the furthest point from South Korea would be. South Korea is kind of in the middle of the Northern Hemisphere, so that's a little bit of a, that's a tough one. Maybe South America, I don't know, but that one kind of threw me off. And you see here, it's very easy for you to bomb your scores on Wonky Wednesday. Again, that's why it is important to still figure out where in the world you are. Because one horrible guess and you are Dunskies. Oh my goodness, this is a big river. That is a big river or lake. I can't tell if that's mile per hour. Why is the Google car? Come on, Google car. Drop the hammer. We gotta get going. Oh my god, I got 8 seconds left. I have no idea where this is. I saw a bike path. I'm gonna assume it's North America. So let's go for Australia. Why not? Let's say far western Australia. Hey, look at that, 20 points. Wow, that is a heck of a guess. Where was that? It was in Maryland. So it was actually a little bit south of Ocean City. I've been there before. 20 points. I think that might be the best guess I've ever had on Wonky Wednesday. Good lord. Now that is a pretty good accomplishment there. See, you got to know. You've got to know. And obviously I didn't know because I was a complete total guess. And there's the guy taking the Google pictures apparently. What? I can't even move from here. All right. Well, this is kind of lame. Well, we're somewhere very snowy. So we know we're in the Northern Hemisphere. I'm gonna go back for far south South America. Let's put it that way. Make guess. That was in Germany, really? Huh. Well, that one you can't really. I mean, it's impossible for anyone to know that. Anyone says, "Yeah, I know it was right there in Germany." You're full of a nerd. I do not believe you. I don't know where the furthest southern position. I guess Alaska may have been a further distance away from that. I don't know. But 129 points, not very good. But that 20-point guess, whew. Hoo doggy, that was a pretty good guess. Are those orange trees? They are orange trees. Oh, that looks good. Are they? It could be lemon. On closer inspection, maybe? I don't know. Those look like those leaves out there. Anyway, I'm paying too much attention to the foliage around here. I have no idea. I'm going to assume they're oranges, so let's go for... It's either South America or somewhere in Europe. Yeah. So that was apparently in Italy. Is that right? Yep. That was in Italy. I'm not really sure what fruit that was. They look like oranges, but they also had a look of lemons as well. But the leaves look like orange leaves to me. 161 points, that's the worst guess I had out of all of them. So again, with Wonky Wednesday, it's important to know where you are. It's not just I just put it in the same place every time. Because what happens if you get a South African guess and you put it in South Africa? Then you pretty much bombed your Wonky Wednesday score. Final total is 541. Ew, that's not really a good score at all for Wonky Wednesday. I think I scored at one point when I don't remember what my lowest score is for Wonky Wednesday, but I think it was 200-something. That was a while ago. But again, I do want to thank everyone who has been watching and playing GeoGuessr. I know I love this game, and I do know that a lot of my teacher friends out there have been enjoying incorporating this into their geography lessons for the kids. And let me know what you did, how you did the score. Post your score link down below, and I will check it out when I can. Hope you're having a great Wednesday. Get over the hump day, because we've got 2 days left. Then it's the weekend, and football starts tomorrow. NFL football season starts tomorrow with the Broncos taking on the Ravens. Should be a lot of fun. I can't wait to see how bad my fantasy football team does this year. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. Have a great day. And, of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.